Hello traders and investors, welcome back to the Trend Trader channel. As we mentioned in the previous video, the earnings, they are coming back. We're starting to see more and more companies being added to the companies that will be reporting earnings. So from the week of the April 15th going to the end of April, or maybe even mid-May 2024, we might see a lot of companies coming up with their earnings. As you can see from this list, there are plenty of interesting companies such as Goldman Sachs, ASML, TSM, there's Netflix, American Express. So as usual, we're gonna cover those companies that we are only able to cover, since we won't be able to cover everything. Before we start, I would like to ask those who haven't subscribed to please consider subscribing, and just make sure when you're watching the video, you can look at the video description if there is a specific company that you want to check if that company is covered. We do a timestamp so that you don't spend time watching all the video if there's a specific company that you need that you want to watch. Otherwise, you can just watch the video at 1.5 times speed so that you can easily go through. For those people that are first time viewers, so when we cover the anticipated earnings, we actually cover the technical analysis of the companies with the goal of identifying those companies that have the potential to give us trading opportunities. So there are companies that have good fundamentals or that can report a good result that won't be covered in the video. We're just looking at those companies that have, in terms of technical analysis, it is clear where we can place our buy orders or sell orders, and if we can add those companies onto our watch list. So let us begin. We mentioned that ASML, it's a semiconductor stock. It is one of the companies that has done very well in year 2024. You saw that when they came out with their result, the stock, it just rallied up there. So let us take a step back a bit for those people that are not familiar with technical analysis. So in this case, you can see that ASML formed something that looked like a cup and pattern handle. So you can see here, this is a nice bullish continuation pattern. This is the pivot point there. That is where you are supposed to enter to buy that particular position. So even if ASML did not come up with earnings, obviously the earnings can come up and be a catalyst for an upward movement. But just by looking at the chart patterns alone, without the knowledge of fundamental analysis, you can still find trading opportunities. So it is the same thing that we see with ASML. We have that nice cup and handle with the pivot point there breaking away. So where we are at this moment, the stock is just consolidating above this level, somewhere around $984. So once the earnings they come out, we have a buy stop order. We are anticipating a move above this pivot point. There we're expecting the share price to continue to move further up. If you have been watching our channel for a while, you know that whenever we're looking to buy a stock that is breaking out of a consolidation range, we always have a stop loss just below that breakout level, because it's possible that there could be a downside. So we don't want to be caught with our pants down. So this is how we are planning to participate in ASML going into the earnings this coming week. If you already have a position, you might not want to have a too tight of a stop loss, because obviously depending on the outcomes of the earnings report, the stock can be too volatile and it can unnecessarily trigger your stop loss. So you need to look at your position, if you have a profit cushion there, and then you can adjust your stop loss so that it accounts for any potential volatility on the downside that can take you out of the trade unnecessarily. So now let us look at another stock that is associated with Semiconductor. This is the Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company. If you look around the news, the US government is trying to lobby this company to come and produce more chips in the US soil. Some of the production happens in Taiwan. As the name says, it's a Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing. We know that we are in an AI frenzy. A lot of companies, they are talking AI. So we need those chip to keep on coming. So this is another company that can potentially benefit, whether it's an AI bubble, whatever you want to call it. But this stock can benefit, and you as a trader, you can also participate and then get the spoils of that particular company. So what is worth noting is that the stock is trading above that historical high levels there. So that is interesting for us, because now we know that if we participate in this and there is a breakout on the upside, we will be looking to be in a position in a stock that is breaking to new all-time highs. Why do we like all-time highs? There's no resistance on the upside. If you're buying a stock that is trying to recover, there is always going to be a resistance level. To make an example, we see ASML, it traded above this price, so creating something that looks like a range before it broke down at this level. So now you can go back in time and say ASML got support at this particular level. But if you look at that recover, here there was this potential resistance level when the stock was moving up. Wherever there was a previous stop like this stop here, you see that the stock had a stop or a brief of a breather in there, as the buyers and sellers were interested in that level to see how the bulls and the bears are going to behave around that particular price action. However, once the stock is trading on a new territory, then there is no resistance level. The stock can easily go up. We're not saying that the stock is just gonna fly up, but if you look at this territory here, it was once that historical or the all-time high at that particular time. As you can see, there was no resistance level there until there was that consolidation. So that is one of the reasons why we are interested in buying stocks that are breaking into new all-time highs. So that's it with ASML. We're looking for a breakout on the upside so that you can participate in that particular position, obviously with a stop loss just below that 144 level in case the share price reverses. Now let us look at Netflix. Again, this is another stock. It came out with good earnings in the previous report, but also the stock, we've been looking at this particular level. You can see we already have a position, so we're anticipating that Netflix was going to close this gap. You see, now we just spoke about a potential resistance level. Although Netflix managed to break above this particular level, but it is struggling to push upward to come and reach this previous all-time high, because there is this particular level in there. We believe that if that level did not exist, the stock could have easily moved up there. We are already having a position. As you can see, the position is somewhere near 1:1 risk to reward ratio. So we're going to leave our position as it is. However, we're going to have a buy stop order above $701 there, because that would be a new all-time high if the stock manages to break above this level. So as current shareholders of this particular company, we're just gonna be keeping an eye there with a buy stop order in anticipation that the company is gonna come out with a good earnings report, and also with anticipation that the stock can potentially break above $701. Then we are going to participate in that particular trade. And we saw last week there are some things that are going on between Iran and Israel. So war is good for other people. It's not good for the people that are involved in that war, especially the civilians. But we saw that gold performed well, and other commodities such as platinum. And that also led to the rise in the share price of those commodity miners or commodity stocks. Another company that is involved in commodities is Alcoa Capital. They will be coming up with their result, but also we are looking for potential trade opportunity there. So this green line is our filter for some other stocks, not all stocks. If they are above this green level, then they do give us a buy signal. So the first thing that we notice, the price of Alcoa is already above this level, so we are looking for buy opportunities there in that particular stock. So now if we zoom in a bit, you can see that the stock has managed to trade above that low level there. It also managed to stay above this recent high there. So this also tells us now that the stock has a nice bullish momentum. You can see the line is also, the moving average is also trying to point further up there. So obviously we're expecting that if the news they come out, they're positive, the share price is going to continue to trade high. However, if the news is negative, then we can see the share price either to come back to retest this recent breakout level. If the news are severe, then maybe it can come to test this increasing moving average. So that is the level that we are planning to trade. But remember, it's not just Alcoa Corporation that is doing well in the commodity space. Alcoa is just a company that will be giving earnings this coming earnings. If there are better companies in other sectors, whether it's gold miners or platinum miners, you can also look for opportunities there. You don't always need to look for opportunities from the companies that will be reporting their earnings report. And then another sector that is doing okay so far, despite everything that is happening around the world, is the financial sector. So we're looking at a Goldman Sachs there to see how they have performed. So at the recording of this video, the earnings report from Goldman Sachs is already out. So this is the level of interest that we are looking to see, that all-time high there. So we're expecting that GS at some point will break above this level, and then that is where we want to have a buy stop order in anticipation for an upside. As you can see, we like to trade stocks as they are on the top right hand corner. Any stock that is at this level, it interests us. Anything that is declining, that is at the bottom right hand, does not excite us at all. We avoid those particular companies. We only focus on companies that are in an uptrend. So you can see Goldman Sachs, it's easily, at any time, it's possible that it can print a new all-time high, and that is when we want to initiate our long position. And then finally, let us look at American Express to see the price action of American Express, and then maybe we can expect something from there. One thing that is clear is that you can see there was the breakout from that all-time high, and then the stock started trading above $200 per share. There is a nice upward movement there on the moving average. Again, the stock now where it is, we can say that it is a consolidating there at this level between just below 230 and somewhere around just above 210. So it will take some time because the earnings are coming at the end of the week, but we're expecting the share price of American Express to come back and trade at this level, with the possibility of the share price breaking above this level. Obviously, if the share price managed to break above this level, we will then initiate another long position. For all the companies that we say we are going to initiate a long position, it's a first come, first served basis. So we might have some of these companies in our portfolio, but we might also not have some of these companies in our portfolio, especially if they don't come quick with the breakout, and we see breakout in other companies, because at the end of the day, we are in the market to make money, not to wait for companies to set up. But if they do set up and we have cash, then we always take advantage of those particular companies. So that's it for today. If you found value in this video, please make sure that you smash that like button. If you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. We will see you in the next video.